Hey there, it's Patmos and nice of you to join me for yet another episode with Medieval Dynasty. And although we still have a very small dynasty, I think there are quite a few things that we can do. For instance, we have a house to spare now, because we completed it last time. So we might get an extra family in, if we can find the right people, of course. And, well, there's some other things to do, but first let's go to Gustovia, because then we can deliver Alwyn's water skin. And we can really make him happy with that, and of course it helps to finish a quest. Let's take a few feathers with us. And, well, is there anything else that we can take and maybe sell? I want to keep this. Let's see, we keep the firewood, we keep the fur, we keep the leather. We don't need planks at this point, so yeah, let's just get rid of everything that we don't need at this point. Yeah, that's it. Alright, well, let's head to town. Deliver the water skin. After that, we're going to construct a barn. First, let's just go to town. Maybe we can even find a good villager there. Although, I think I remember from last time that there weren't any villagers available anymore. But we'll see. Maybe the next season a new person will become available. That differs from time to time. It's still fall, which is good. No snow yet. But of course, the next season will probably be winter. Well, I know the next season will be winter, of course, but I think the next day it will already start. That can be quite a challenge to keep warm. But that might also be a good period in time to just work on our village. So get extra houses, get a barn going and stuff like that. That could really help out. Although I'm not sure. Yeah, we still can build 10 buildings, so we can do quite a lot of building in winter. And that can help us to stay warm. And of course we can always get a few torches. That can also help to keep us warm. And, well, running around finding some warm clothing can also really help. I know there's clothing out there that just keeps you warm, so you don't have to light a torch every now and then to stay warm. And that's really helpful in the winter time. Ooh, there's somebody going to sit here. Are you available to join my village? No, you are not. Unfortunate. Well, then let's first find Alwyn. There he is, walking, I think. Slowly catching. Yeah, there he is. Hi, Alwyn. I'm back and I bring good news. The job is done. Here you go. Thank you. This will help me a lot. I have some onion seeds here. Maybe you will make good use of them. Oh, thank you. Didn't have a lot of trouble with the quest, did you? Let's see. The sewer didn't have leather to repair the water skin, so I had to hunt down some wild animals for supplies. Piece of cake. So you can craft tools and hunt. You are truly amazing. Oh, thank you. My mother was always pretty handy with a bow and spear. She used to take me hunting from an early age. I envy you. My father only taught me how to work in the fields. Oh, remember that. In the end, you are the one who shapes your own fate. Well, that's true. Yeah, it makes sense. It's time for me to leave. Till next time. Alright, we get 20 onion seeds and some dynastic reputation. Well, that's great. So this quest is done. We have to wait for the next day, but we're not going to wait in the village for the next day, of course. I think we're just gonna run home. Since there's no villagers to be asked here to join us, or she should be... No. Well, what we could do is just swing by Borova and see if there's anyone there that will join the village. I hope a good hunter, because we still have a job position available for a hunter. And that will really help us to get the food that we really need. And I basically want an excess amount of meat, because we can use that in the end to make some fertilizer. Now that's going to be for the future, and when we're going to do that I'll explain it to you, but if you have a lot of excess food, you can create your own fertilizer with it, and that's really helpful. And I'll show you later. Let's just swing by the village, see if there's anyone good enough that we want in our village, and then we'll head back and start building the barn to do some actual farming, which will be really nice. We can grow our own foods. Well, let's see, here we have the campfire and a few people sitting by. No, there's just one guy there, and yeah, he's not what we want. So, I guess no luck in this village as well. Yeah, the rest is not up for joining. Should we go to Baranica? Maybe. Let's just walk around, because it is really important to get extra people. There's just not a lot of good people around. I've played quite a few trial games, of course, to get to familiarize with the game, etc. And I haven't come across a lot of villages yet where there's just no good people around. I'm going to grab myself a few stones, by the way. Not going to take too many so that we get too heavy. But, yeah. Just carrying a few stones can help us later on if we start to build the barn and we have to lay the foundations, etc. And with housing as well. We're going to need a lot of stone if we want to start building stone houses. And in the end, building stone houses is really worth it. Your villagers will get more happy and stuff like that if you build stone housing. So that's really something to do. Oh, by the way, we have two villagers that are hungry, so we'll have to bring them some food soon. Ah, I guess we did get a lot of raw meat, but we have to prepare it first before they can eat it, of course. So going back to the village after we swing by Baranica, I don't know the real name. We'll be good to make some food and then we can do some construction. Same time, let's keep our eyes open for any treasures. Sometimes you will find a chest, but usually you have to go a little bit more into the forest compared from what we're doing. But there might also be a cart laying around or something that we can make good use of. Yeah, this is a cart spot. We can see a torch, that's good for winter. Or anything else here? Sticks. I think we already took most here. At least that's what I remember. But apparently we missed a torch. Alright, well that's interesting. Now let's head to the village. So that after this we can bring some food home. Now you'll see in the management screen that their mood will drop slowly because they don't have food. But later on it will get back to its normal amount as soon as we give them food. So, and it can run really low. It has to go to like minus 100 before people will really leave your village. So don't worry if it starts to drop a bit. Even if it's like minus 50, you still have a little time to make sure that they get happy again. Of course, if you don't provide houses and stuff like that, it will drop pretty quickly. And then it can be quite tough to actually raise it again. All right, let's see. We have a good hunter here. So yes, I want you in my village. He is 26, that's a good age. Great, see you there. Are you available? Yes. Well, she's not that good, but I think I want her in.
Hello there.
She's 27. Alright, I'm creating a new settlement. I'm looking for new people. Are you willing to join me? Yes, she is. Well, we can put them both in the same house, so that's good. So let's put her into the empty house. And I don't have a job for her yet, but we can provide her with a job soon. Now this guy can live with her, that's good. And then we can make him a hunter, and this will get us a lot of extra food. Since he's a level 3 hunter. So that will be working out great. Problem is, we have a well and a woodshed, we have a hunting lodge. And yeah, so I think now it's time to head back to town. So we're going to go here. And while we head back, we build some housing and a few jobs for these people. Or at least one job. Let's think about what we can make her do. I don't think we can build the herbalist yet. We do have a woodshed. Maybe we can build another woodshed so that we can get a really good amount of wood. We're going to need a lot anyway, so that might be a good option actually, because we'll get a lot more than we have right now. Right, we can see our town there in the distance. Still small, but well, let's see, we can carry 4 more stones. So let's make sure that we carry a few extra stones while going to town. That might be nice. Yep, here's stones laying around. One, two, three, four. Perfect. All right, so now we're completely filled out. So this is a way to make good use of your travels. Just make sure that you take all that you need with you. And now there's still plenty of stones around near our house, and we took the ones from further away. Although with every change of the season, new resources will be added on the map, also around your village, so you get a few extra stones around and stuff like that. So don't worry too much about it, but yeah, it's interesting. Alright, here we have our village, we can see everybody's working. I think we can already build a kitchen. And that will be really interesting. This should be the food storage, yes. So, can we build a kitchen? That's basically a important thing. This is the wrong one. Let's see, where is it? Services, where's the kitchen? Usually find it blindly and now I miss it. Well, how can I not find the kitchen? It's just the storages, that's okay. Services, the builder's hut, production. Ah, here's the kitchen. Yeah, we can't build it yet. Alright, so let's start working on the barn then. Here we have the farming fields. So maybe the barn could go here. I think this would be a nice spot. So let's see. Building, farming, and we build a barn. Can it fit here? Yes, it can fit here. Let's just build it right here. Now we have enough stones for the foundation already. Ooh, that I'm really happy with. And after this, I'm kind of hoping we can start working on the kitchen. So we have to... Ooh, they all have food again. That's great. Apparently that's fixed. Yeah, we only have some roasted meat. Why don't we have any food coming from the hunter's hut? They seem to be able to do all that they need to. They have the skills, they have the knife. They should be creating 75 meat a day. Well, maybe they're just starting to work. I'm really hoping that we get some food in soon so that they can start to eat that. There's no food in here, I think. No. Alright, so we'll have to come back later then. Ooh, we need to take some logs, by the way, for the barn. Ooh, we got a lot of logs. Now we can only carry a little bit. 5. So maybe we should get rid of some stuff that's really heavy. So let's get rid of the bronze axe. Let's get rid of the iron axe. That's really a lot of weight that we take along that we don't really need at this point. Let's get rid of the 2 wooden spears. That means that we can carry a lot more other stuff. Yeah, let's get rid of the 2 stones because we don't need them now. This means that we can carry quite a few extra logs. We're just a little bit too heavy now. It's fine. This will help out in the building process. Yeah, we already took enough logs to finish the framing. So we need a lot of sticks. Luckily, there's plenty of sticks around. Maple stump. Yeah, I don't want the maple stump to be gone. Let's just keep it. Just another stick. Well, let's see if we have any sticks in here. And some... we need a few more logs as well. So we can carry 9 easily. There's 10 sticks in here. Oh, that's not too many, but at least it's a few. And, well, we'll just need to get some sticks. So that's what we're going to do then. Let's see how far we can get building with this barn. And hopefully we can get quite far. I think we can, at least with the logs. And then we can just bring in some new. I think we'll have to wait until the hunter guy is here. The new hunter that we hired. If he's here, then he can really help out and hunt some food. That can make the difference, I think. Right, well, 1/3 of the barn is done already. We lost our hammer. So we need sticks to create a new hammer. And we need sticks to finish the thing, of course. So let's grab sticks. We need at least 10 to finish the hammer. So we can build a hammer now. And then we need a lot more sticks. I was planning on getting rid of all the... Yeah, there's sticks here too. I was planning on using all the logs first, but we ran out of a hammer, and now we can just run around and grab some sticks. Although this takes some time. Maybe find a few good growing sticks. Come on, get me the sticks. That's good. 18 sticks already. So there's sticks here. Well, the building does take some time, of course. Gathering all the goods, but this is also what gives you the points that you need to unlock new technologies, right, so you can do new buildings. So it takes time, but it's also really needed. You really need new technology points and to unlock those new buildings, especially if you want a kitchen or something like that. We need some food ourselves soon, by the way. We did so much work that now we are dirty again, so we'll have to get into the water, take a bath. Otherwise a lot of people won't talk to us. Alright, this is done. So we need at least 2 more logs for the inside and quite a few logs for the outside. As well as straw. So I guess let's eat something first. We have 3 meat, so that's something. Let's get some water and take a bath. And then we grab some straw as well. Because that can really help us out to finish the roof. And straw is here anyway. So let's go and get it. Though there's not a lot of straw left, I think, because we already took out a lot. So we'll have to search for it a bit. Though, there should be still a lot of reed that we can use for straw. Never ran out in this area before, so don't think that'll happen this time. Just have to do some searching for it. Maybe if we go a little bit further, there will be more and more left. And, well, in the next spring, there will be quite a bit available again, so it will just... New reed will be added. Which will be nice, so every now and then you can just go back. And of course, when you get things like the extraction hut, we can tell our villagers to just grab this stuff for us. Now, I think we need 6 times 8 reed, so we need quite a lot. So let's just make sure that we have plenty of it. Get like 50 or something. It should probably do the trick, so let's try it out. Now we'll swing by the storage here as well, see if we have some extra logs that we can use. Probably have a few, yes, 4, so that's nice. And let's go start working on the roof. Our guy's quite tired. Let's regain a little bit of stamina and then start hammering again. There we go. Now I still get the message in the left top corner every now and then that somebody needs food, and then a little later it'll be gone. Let's check the map. Yeah, both the villagers from Baranica already arrived, so they should be working now. So I guess in a little while we should start to pile up some food, but apparently not yet. Two villagers working in the farming business should be plenty to produce enough food, more than we can eat. Apparently they have a little bit of a hard time doing so. Alright, we need one log for this piece, one log for the other, so that's two. We need two for the inside still, so that's four. So I think we need four more logs and then it's alright. So let's take our axe, chop down a tree. Although this is a spruce tree and I want a maple tree. Because that's what we get the four logs from. Like this, so we only have to chop down one tree. Get the four logs that we need and then the barn will be done. Oops, there comes the tree. Let's step aside. Luckily it won't kill us if it falls on us, but might be good to just make sure that we... Alright, oh, here's it. I was thinking I missed one log, but there it is. Here's our nearly completed barn. One. That's done. And now this is done. Alright, the barn is done. 500 dynastic reputation. We completed the barn. And the next mission will be to build 15 buildings. Alright, we're not going to go straight into that now. Let's first check. Is there finally some food in here? Some meat? No. So maybe we should help out a little bit. We check the management screen. We should be able to see if they have the tools that they need. And they still do. Maybe we should just help out hunting a little bit. Hunt a few animals. We can take our bow for that. That's really interesting. But let's take some stuff to the barn that we need in the farm. So for instance, all the seeds can go there. The fertilizer can go there. Ooh, let's take the arrows with us if we're going to do some hunting. Ooh, we got a lot of planks. That's really good. Ooh, the recurve bow. Which bow is better? Ooh, the recurve bow is better. So let's... like this. Anything else? Yeah, let's take the wheat towards the farm. I think that's it. So, oh, and the rods needs to go to the barn. Yeah, this is it. So let's take this stuff to the barn. So at least it's in the right building. I won't be assigning any villagers to the barn yet. So that won't be an issue. It doesn't really need to be here. But I just like it when it is. So it is in the right spot. And if I'm trying to find something, I know where to go. Alright. All this stuff is now here. That's it. Now let's go and help out our hunters for a bit. Well, this is the first step. To meet for ourselves. I think we can set a new trap. Set it right here so we can get some extra stuff out of that. Let's see. We had a spear, I believe. Yeah, it's on number 5. Let's put it on number 3. And then put the bow on number 5. If you have a bow, you need to equip your arrows. You can just click the arrow and hit the F button and it will be equipped right here. Now we have the arrows equipped as well. And that can really help out in hunting the bigger animals. Especially stuff like boar, etc. Because the arrows will do quite the damage. Now, of course, boars will come after us, so we'll have to be a little bit careful. But if we can find them, we might be able to get some good meat. And right here we have bigger animals, which is also interesting. Although I don't think we can just kill one of these with one arrow. So maybe it will be a tedious hunt. We'll find out. Let's see, there's a big one, there's one. I'd like to shoot them in the head because that will guarantee the most damage. But that's also the hardest thing to do. Alright, so there's one walking here. It's walking away from us. Let's see if we can swing around a bit and then try and hit it in the head. Something like that. I think it spotted us. I really hate hitting walking animals because I just miss all of the time. There we go. Yeah, that was a hit. That's two hits. Did it lose the arrows? Yes, it lost the arrows. Always check for your arrows. Because you can use them again and you can see that we're still 100%, so they were still really good. And that's really worth it, because these arrows are very strong. I think with one more arrow it should be down. So let's see if we can hit it. It's running away, of course, but yeah, maybe we can. Yep, there it is. Alright, 3 arrows and it's down. Where's the arrow? Still in there, so we can just pick it. And let's skin it. So this should provide us with some food. Maybe we can hunt another one, then we'll have... Yeah, 22 meat. Alright, that's good. Let's go and find another one. And hopefully... this will solve food issues for a while. Alright, let's go check. There's one. There's another one. There's probably only 3 around. Ooh, here they are. Ooh, nice. There's a deer, I think. Well, that's just one arrow for the deer. That's really nice. I wonder if we also get the arrow back. So let's take a look in the top left corner. Deer skull. No, no arrow. So the arrow should be... well, it's gone. Maybe it broke or something like that. Oh, it's fine. Alright, we got some good meat again. Should we continue hunting? Well, maybe. Let's see if it stops walking. We can try it. I think I missed. Yeah, I missed. Oops. Well, that happens every now and then. Not that good, actually. Ooh, here we have another deer. We take that. Just needs to stop walking, I think. Hunting a deer with one arrow would be great. There it is. No, that didn't work out. Well, here's the arrow. 4 arrows now. Where's the other one? Right there. Here it is. Where's the deer? There. I think this is the one. So one extra arrow might just do the trick. They could also just bleed out. That could be a thing. Oh, now it's running away again. That's not really what I wanted to see. Ah, there it is. So it's running away very far. Alright, I think it's time to just head back and prepare all the food that we gained. We need to eat ourselves. And, yeah, we got quite far away from the village. We need some water ourselves. We need to feed ourselves. And this will help out make all the villagers happy. And if they have food, they'll work more efficiently. So let's go to a fire, prepare the meat, and then share it with the others in the food storage. I still wonder why we keep running out, though, because there should be plenty of meat for everyone. So that is a little issue, but yeah, let's just go to a house, light a fire, prepare the meat. I think that'll be good. Light a fire, yes, craft some meat. So there's 40 meat to be crafted. That will take its time. But it is really important that you keep all your villagers happy, that you keep them fed. The happier they are, the better they'll work. So that's really good. And, well, even though this takes time, this can be automated, of course. We just need to unlock the kitchen. And when we do, we can just assign the free villager that we have. We have one free villager still. To just roast the meat for us. That will really feed everybody in the village. So now this way it's done also, because, well, just take 3 seconds, I think, or 2.5. 3 seconds to roast one piece of meat. So 40 pieces of meat times 3 seconds. That's quite a while, but, well, we get there. And then this will be able to feed our village for quite some time. And that can also give the hunters the time to really start hunting. Because I think if somebody is hungry, they will either stop working or work with a lot less efficiency. And that's really not helpful if we try to get more meat. So this might really help out to switch things around. Now we can see we're already over halfway, so that's really good. Maybe we should stop right now. And put this... yeah, we unlocked the kitchen, that's great. Put this in the food storage, so now that they can eat. We can just put all in the food storage, that's fine. just this 15 and this 25. They can now start to eat. And we can start to plan a kitchen and put the other girl to work. No handcrafting. We need to build. And build a kitchen. Now, it's a small building. It doesn't have to be big. We can just situate it right here next to the food storage. We need 8 stone for it. All right. Don't think there's any stone close by. Although there might be in the next season. Oh, I forgot to eat myself. So let's grab ourselves some meat from the storage and start eating. But I think now in the... with winter coming, we are doing okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. Alright, let's eat it straight away. 1, 2. Oh, we're not completely filled up, but that's okay, because when you sleep from one season to another, normally everything is filled again. So all of your food, water, stamina and stuff, that's all completely refilled. That's really nice. Especially if you run a little low on food like we have lately. We don't have to completely eat ourselves a full belly because it will be filled up anyway. Alright, 6 stone, 7 stone, 8 stone. We'll just take 10 to be sure, but I thought it was 8. Let's head back. I think I'm going to finish the construction of the kitchen the next day and start the winter, because I don't really like the winter time. You get cold and stuff like that, so I enjoy it more if it's spring again. So we're going to go through the winter pretty quickly, I think. Alright, we need 8 logs. Let's first just go to sleep. Get to the next season. There we go. And now it should be winter time. A lot of light, a lot of white. Ooh, interesting. A traveling merchant is visiting your settlement. He presents you his wares. Tells stories about faraway lands. He saw. Also, he says that he can teach you a few tricks to get better deals for a price, of course. Alright, we can give him coins, and then we can get a diplomacy skill. And diplomacy skill is really good. So yeah, I think we should get some advice. So let's take this option and choose the answer. Let's see. Plus 500 skill experience points in diplomacy. That's really nice. I like that. And yeah, we slept, so that's good. We got a new diplomacy level. Let's go check it out. And we got 2 points. And if we do the barter one, we get a 10% better selling price. And if we do it again, we get a 20% better selling price. And I really want that. That means that everything we sell now will give us a better price. And that's totally worth it. Alright, let's now head to the storage, because I believe we have some warm clothing here. Yeah, we have a cap, which is a plus 10% cold protection. Let's take that. We have fur capulets, 20% cold protection, and thick leather gloves. I don't know if we can wear it all, or some things should go together, but we'll see. Let's put on the hat, and the capulets, and maybe the gloves. Yeah, that works. Alright, so we should be better protected against the cold now, which also means that we need... let's pick some logs, by the way. We should be needing less torches, which is good. Alright, let's start working on the kitchen again, so that our lady friend in the village can start to cook. Alright, we need some extra logs for this, and... I think we can get those by taking our shovel and taking out a few logs that are in the way here anyway. I want to use this land at a certain point, so we can just take a few logs from these stumps. In the beginning I thought, well, let's just keep them around. They'll grow into new trees, but we don't need trees in the village at this point. And we can really use this land later for farming and housing and stuff like that. So this is working out just as I intended to. There we go. Oh, we need some sticks, of course. Alright, let's use the other log as well. Let's go grab some sticks. Here we are. Ooh, there's sticks. Sticks, come on, yes. 1, 2. Oh, this is good. And I'm really curious to see now how the food will be done. If we now give the villagers enough time to actually start hunting their own good food. Keep checking your management screen though. Keep making sure that they all have what they need. So we can see in the hunting lodge, nobody needs any, what do you call it? Any tools, because they have plenty. But just really make sure that they have. All right, we need more sticks. We need some straw. We need more sticks for this side. We need logs. But it has also been 35 minutes now. So I'm going to end this episode. Next time we'll finish the kitchen, put our little lady to work, and then it'll be fine. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up. If you haven't done so, please subscribe to my channel. And of course, I hope to see you in another video. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.